this is an Ork Battle Wagon. This is an Ork Kill Bursta from Forge World. Today we're going to be painting one of these, and I'm going to show you the techniques that I use, the fast techniques that I use to paint my Ork vehicles, all in the same way. I use the same paints, the same techniques across the board, and we get them looking like this. Primarily black, metallics, checkers, and scratches. Very simple, very quick, and very orky, of course. So today we're going to paint this Forge World kit. It was incredibly hard to put together, as are Forge World kits in general. But this one particularly, I'm excited about. It's a very, very cool, super heavy Lord of War choice for Orcs. I'm very keen to get started on this, so that's what we're going to do. First off, I'm going to base it with a Chaos Black spray from Games Workshop, and then we'll get started on the chipping of the armor and then go to the details. So there it is, that's the Kill Bursta tank. Very cool, very big, of course, and a very big gun on the front, so that's fun. So let's get started and let's paint it today. Okay, so here it is. I've sprayed it into black. I've got all over. This is the only piece that isn't stuck in. All the rest is. So try your best to get into all the cracks and crevices that you can. This is quite a detailed tank, so you know, there's quite a bit. It's not so much the same on all Ork vehicles, but on this one particularly it was. Make sure anything that's moving around, you get in behind it with the spray as well, like the turrets for instance, and underneath, not such a big deal, but you know, get as much as you can anyway. So there it is, excuse me. So what I want to do first is just run you through sort of the sequence that I do things in and the reason behind them just quickly. So we're just going to go over to the battle wagon here just briefly. Okay, so there's a turret. I'll just take everything off so it's not falling everywhere. But basically what you can see is I've got four main colors here. So you've got the black, which is prominent. You've got the metallics, which is quite prominent. You've got the checkers and the white, which is, you know, getting there. And then you've also got the brass bits as well. And that order is the order that I place them in. So there's got to be more black than metallics, more metallics than the checkers and whites, and more whites and checkers than brass. So that's the way I do it. Any other color that you want to put on, like red or blue or green or whatever, that's fine. Just go ahead and do that. But they're the colors I use mostly for these in that specific order. So basically the armor is comprised of the black and a grey dry brush to get the edges and the rivets, and also some sponging on of some metallic colours, and then later on we do little scratches, like you can see here. I've got scratches all over the armour like that, up against the front there, and a little bit of sponging on the white as well. So it's quite easy, quite simple. So we're going to apply that to the big, so here it is, it's ready to go. I've got my grey, I've got my paper here, and a nice big brush. So I'll go ahead and do that, I'll dry brush this, and then I'll show you the result. Alright, so there's the dry brushing, all done. It's pretty rough, and to be honest, there's probably a couple of places where I got a bit of streaking on there. But you know, it is an orc vehicle, so it's not really such an issue. And a lot of these plates will be metallic or otherwise, so not too bad. It's a very detailed kit, so you know, lots of rivets and lots of edges. So you know, dry brushing really didn't take that long. The edges pick up the paint quite nicely, and you can see that's all highlighted, ready to go for the chipping. So the chipping, I've got my little sponge here, a bit of packing sponge in my palette. We're going to dip this in Ironbreaker and dab on a hell of a lot of chipping on the armor. There's going to be a lot of it, so this may take a little bit longer than the dry brushing, but still a very quick process. And we're going to do this before we start doing all of the other paint work, because we're going to use a different color to chip the different colors of paint work later on. But because the black is the largest bit, we'll do that all first. So let's get started. So there it is. That is the chipping done. Now it looks quite heavy, and it is, but later on when we paint the rest of the panels, probably these corrugated ones and the star pattern panels will be metallic and copper. You'll have a few panels here and there of checkers, and you know, a lot of other details. So it looks heavy, and it is, but purposefully, because there's going to be a lot more detail to paint on this. But that's the first done, and that's the black armor basically finished. Later on, as I said, towards the end, we'll put the scratches, which will blend that chipping in with the rest of the effect. So there it is. Next up, we're going to do all of the bare metallic areas, like I was saying, the corrugated iron pieces, a few panels here and there. Now we'll have a look at the battle wagon. I've got a panel here and there painted in the various metallics. You know, all the tracks, of course, which is quite a bit. We'll do the large barrel on the big gun, and just little details here and there, nothing in particular, just be random about it. Here's the turret of the battle wagon. You see just little bits and pieces, linings, hinges, yeah, just details like that. So we'll go and do that now. We're going to use Leadbelcher for that. Okay, so I'm halfway through. I've painted a few panels here. I just want to mention that some of these panels that I'm painting with Leadbelcher are actually going to be bronze later on. And the reason I'm painting them with the Leadbelcher is a very good base for all metallics, whether it's gold, brass, bronze, copper, or just the silver. So this piece, for instance, will be the bronze. I've put Leadbelcher on there for the fact that, you know, bronze will go over there very, very nicely, the same is for a lot of pieces. Now the entire engine is actually going to be mostly bronze, with the odd metallic in there, so Leadbelcher will be the base color for that that whole assembly as well, and then we'll go with the bronze over the top later on. Alright, so I've gone ahead and done all the metallics, that includes the tracks and the guns. Don't forget the little handles here and there, and the entire back end the engine over there as well. So that's it, that's what it looks like. Now, to do the brass or the bronze, I do it in a very specific way. So what I'll do first is all of the metallics that we've done so far we'll wash with Agrax Earthshade, a nice thick coat. We'll let that completely dry. We'll paint the brass on to the various parts that we want brass, and then we'll do another coat of Agrax Earthshade on all the metallics again, including the brass. So you get two layers of Agrax Earthshade on all the metallic areas and one layer on the bronze areas. So I'll go ahead and do that now. I'm going to do one layer of Agrax Earthshade. I'll paint on the brass and do one more layer of Agrax Earthshade, and then I'll come back. Okay, so that's what it looks like so far. Okay, so here we are. I've done the first layer of Agrax Earthshade across the model. You can see it's darkened down the color quite a bit, but we are going to do another layer after we've put the bronze on. I'm using Sycorax Bronze for the bronze color. It generally goes over the metallics in one layer, but if you do see some streaking, of course, put a second layer on when it's dried. And then we'll apply the second layer of Agrax Earthshade onto the model. So there we are. I've done the second layer of Agrax Earthshade on top of all the Leadbelcher and also the bronze areas. So the bronze areas again have the one layer, and all the other metallics have two layers of Agrax Earthshade. You can see it's dulled down the armor and the metallics a lot, and we're going to bring that up with some Runefang Steel, a quick dry brush onto the metallics. We're going to focus more on the Leadbelcher. We only really want a very, very small amount on the bronze areas, because we don't want to blend them in too much with the other metallics. So you can see the bronze has become quite brown, a brighter brown, and the metallics are a dull brown. So we want to make sure that they stay very separate to each other, so we get that nice different sort of look and a bit of color variation. Okay, so I just filmed a segment there and realized my microphone was turned off, so I'll just go through what you missed out on. First thing is, obviously, I finished the dry brushing of the metallics there. You can see I've gone all over all the metallics, the tracks included, less so on the brass bronze bits, and I haven't forgotten all the little bits inside here and inside the armor panels there. Now with the cannon itself, I actually dry brushed the segments, focusing more on the front end there, as you can probably see. So it's given it more of a worn sort of shiny look. But you know, a lot of the metallics have their shininess back, but obviously still look dirty and grimy and horrible, like Ork gear should be. Now I've also started putting on the white panels, getting ready for the checkers to go on. So really, when you're choosing the checkers parts, try to randomize it, but also focus on the bits that you know you want the person to look at. So for instance, there's quite a bit on the front of the tank. I want, you know, that's where the focus is, the big cannons there. That's what you're going to be looking at as an opponent or a player most of the time. So, you know, I've gone for quite a bit on the front there. But again, I've gone back to the formula, making sure that there's more black than there is metallics, more metallics than there is the white and checkers areas, and more white checkers areas than there are the brass areas. So again, using that formula to sort of even it out. So on this side, you can see I've got quite a bit of metallics. There's obviously more black than anything else. There's two white bits and one bronze, and so on and so forth. So I've just made sure that formula sticks to the all of the tank. I haven't done any on the back. I think there's enough detail at the back. I don't think putting checkers on there is going to really, you know, help anything. So that's what I've done. I've done three layers of Ulthuan Grey, and the reason I use Ulthuan Grey is it's slightly off-white. It's not a pure white, and putting pure white on a model like this that is already very, very black and dark and dull is kind of risky. You end up putting too much brightness into the model. So Ulthuan Grey is an off-white. It's not a totally white, but it's not totally grey. Somewhere in between, and it works as a really good in-between white to put on here. So we're going to put the checkers over these parts. You can even, and what I might do is paint a couple of little tiny panels here and there with white and just leave them white, and we'll dirty them up later and we won't put our checkers on those bits. So I might go through and figure out a couple of little ones here and there, not too many, just to have pure white, which also adds a bit of variation to the model as well. Okay, so that's what I've done, that's where I'm up to. What I'll do now is I'll paint those little panels I was just talking about, and then I'll show you how I go ahead and do the checkers. There's quite a lot of checkers to do, so it's going to take a fair while. But yeah, absolutely really enjoying painting this model. It looks really good so far. All right, so I've painted this little panel here and this little panel here. They'll be left white. We're not going to put checkers on them, but all the other white panels we're going to put checkers on. So the way I do this is I use Vallejo Air Model Black, or Model Air Black. It's already pretty thin. Probably hear how thin that is. It's just water, very watery, ready for an airbrush, basically. The reason I use this is so I don't have to water down Abaddon Black every 5 minutes to get the right consistency. So I just put a drop or two of this on my palette, and I use a very, very fine tip on a small brush, and I go ahead and paint the lines. Now I do the lines for the checkers first, and then I fill them in the checkers afterwards. So I'll just show you what I mean. So a little bit on the brush, and I just paint very thin lines. They don't have to be perfectly straight. Just like that. These are very wonky so far, but you'll notice that they'll start to blend together once I put the checkers in. So just roughly outline the lines. They don't have to be perfectly spaced either. Just do them roughly. Remember, Orcs painted these, or Gretchen painted these, so you know, they don't use complex physics to paint their vehicles. Just get it in there. Okay, so there you go. Pretty quick, and I've just done the angular outline there, and now we'll do the opposite angle. Okay, so there's the outline of the checkers. That's what you want. Okay, so we're going to fill that up now using the same paintbrush and the same black. Just pick any square to start with, and you're going to paint it. Just fill it in, just like that. And keep moving to every corner square that's attached to its diagonal. Alright, so there it is. I've done all the checkers, as you can see. There's a little bit of cleaning up to do on my part, a little bit messy in some parts, but I'll clean those up off camera. So that's pretty much it. The checkers are on. You can see I've done different sizes, different angles, and sort of different orientations there. I've left those two small panels, as I said I would, empty. And it's looking quite good, so it's starting to look like an orc tank now. Okay, next step is we're going to start putting a few colors on here. So I want to do that red fuel tank, start doing some of these wires around here, the wires on this side as well, and just a few details like that. So I'll run you through what I do when I do them, and then we can do the scratching on the armor. And that's pretty much going to be it. It's a very, very simple technique. So I'll get started on the red tank and the various wires. I'll show you the colors I use, and we'll get that done. Okay, so here are the colors we're going to use. Primarily, I want to keep the blue and the green to a minimum. I want the yellow and the red to be the primary colors that we use for the cables and various things. The reason I've got Zandri Dust here is that I want to cover all the yellow cables with Zandri Dust first and then put the yellow over top. Otherwise we'll be doing three or four layers of the yellow over the black. It just takes too long. So one layer of this and one layer of the yellow is enough for the yellow parts. I'm using Khorne Red, this is Yriel Yellow, and Khorne Red for the red parts. I've got an old color, which is Snot Green, and Caledor Sky. Okay, so once we've done all the colors for those, we're gonna wash them with Agrax Earthshade and then leave them. Okay, so they'll end up looking grotty and dirty and horrible, which is how you want your orcs to look. And then after that, we'll put on some scratches and also dirty up some of the white parts with a bit of Agrax Earthshade as well. Right, so I've gone ahead and I've colored up the cables. You can see around there, the shade is drying now, but I've done one layer of Agrax Earthshade over those colors. It adds a lot of color, obviously, and variation to the model. So it's a welcome addition. But what we're gonna do now is something I think is far more important, and that is the scratches on the armor. This adds such a lively aspect to the model, and I think it's definitely worth doing and spending a good amount of time on. So what you're going to need is Ironbreaker and Runefang Steel. Ironbreaker you're going to use on the bare black armor panels, and Runefang Steel you're going to use to scratch up some of the already metallic parts that you see and you've already done, like the wheels here as well. So the Runefang Steel is obviously a brighter color than most of the metallics on here, so it'll show up. And Ironbreaker's quite bright still against the black armor, but it'll sort of match in because you've already used Ironbreaker on the armor at the beginning anyway. So this is the battle wagon of mine. You can see there's quite a lot of scratches on it, and it adds another dimension to the armor. See some scratching on the panels there, a hell of a lot on the front, and it gives it a really good look, I think. So we're going to do that now, and I'll show you what I mean. So get your Ironbreaker. You'll want to thin this down a little bit on your palette. So a little bit of water on the palette there, and we'll thin it out. So it needs to be quite thin, quite watery. And the reason being is so that it comes off the brush nice and smoothly. And what we're going to do is I'll pick a panel like this, for example. I'm just going to put scratches in various different locations, probably a bit thick there. Try to crisscross some of them. And along the panels like that, just gives that extra dimension to the model. Scratch up some of the rivets as well when you come across them. And try and make sure that that tip is quite sharp on the brush, and just streak it across like that. So you get these nice sharp scratches along the hull. So there it is, that's the tank pretty much complete. There is one more thing we need to do, and then a little bit of a surprise. I thought I'd do something special because it's a special model, it's a big model, it's a Forge World model, it's a Lord of War, so I thought, hey, let's do something cool. I'm going to put in writing, in Ork paint writing, across the front, a big red WAR. I've done this on other tanks before, very small and very lightly. I'll give you an example of those in a sec. But that's something I thought I'd show you how to do as well, is how to do some orc riding as well. So I'm going to do that. But right now what we need to do is get our Agrax Earthshade out, get a small brush, and we're going to start putting some dirtiness onto this the checkers. So basically, in the same way that you were doing the scratches, we're just gonna put some dirty marks around the rivets, on all the white bits, just sort of, you know, dirty it up a bit, make it not look so clean. Orcs don't like cleanliness, so just get on there. Around all the rivets and bits like that. There's a few panels here that are messed up, just as if you're doing scratches. Rivets, bits like that. On the front here, lots of dirt, I think, on the front. It's a kind of place you'll find a lot of dirt. Just lather it on and be random, be quick about it. The quicker you are, again, the more random it's going to be. And I might just put a whole load of this sort of over the metallics there as well, just being gentle because it is a good brush. So just making it nice and dirty. This is built by the orcs, remember, so it's got to look like crap, basically. Put it around this big thing, whatever that is. Okay, so here's those white bits I was telling you about earlier on. Make them look nice and dirty, and they just add a little bit of depth to the model. Okay, so here is the example that I was talking about. We've got orcs with a Z written across the side there, and a big WAR along here. So it sort of starts in a dark red and builds up to a red-orange. So the colors we're gonna use for that are Base of Khorne Red, Evil Sun Scarlet, and Troll Slayer Orange. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get a lead pencil, and I'm going to trace out the wah across, make sure I get it right, and then I'll go in with that and the orange, and yeah, I'll show you how that's done. All right, so that's the tank done. There is one thing I want to add to it. I've sort of looked over the model and seen what I like and what I don't like. What I'm gonna add to the model is a little bit of grease in those crevices on this gun using Athonian Camoshade. I'm also gonna do the same to some of the bits in the engine to dirty it up a bit. It is dirty, but it's not dirty enough. And also I want to, in the same way that we did in the Punisher tutorial, I'm gonna put some scorch marks on the end of these barrels and just inside of the lip of this barrel as well. That's pretty much, you could stop there. That's the tank done, basically. I just wanna add a bit more detail to it just because I'm picky and I think the model's worth it. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, now to do the scorch marks, it's quite easy. You need a medium sort of dry brush with the good light bristles. Abaddon Black and some paper towel, and it's simply a matter of stippling. You're dry brushing basically, but you don't want to dry the brush too much. In the case of this flamer, we just want to start stippling it on the end of the flamer like this, and that will build up slowly dark scorch marks on the end of it like that. Very, very easy, very quick to do. That's done pretty much. Just build it up slowly and stipple it on like that. So there's the flamer. We'll do these guns here. Thank you. All right, so that's it. That's the tank done. I'm really, really happy with this. It's turned out exactly how I wanted it to. Nice and damaged, nice and broken, nice and scratched, dirty, rusty. It just looks awesome. I really, really hope that you've got something out of this tutorial. It's how I paint all of my Ork vehicles, from the walkers like Killer Cans and Death Dreads, all the way to trucks, the planes, everything. Any Ork vehicle, this is why I paint them. This is for the Goths, obviously. So nice dark scheme, black and metallic. Big wire across the front. I think that looks really, really cool. It'll be the last thing the enemies see before they die in the big blast of flames from this thing. So really happy with this, and I really hope you enjoyed it. I filmed a how to paint Ork skin tutorial recently, and it sort of hasn't come together yet, so I'm doing that as well, but hopefully that'll be on the channel soon. And many other painting tutorials, of course, as well. And we'll probably see this bad boy featured in the next battle report coming up next week. So let's see what it can kill or what it can't kill. God knows orcs are quite random on the battlefield, but that's why I love them. All right, so take care, everyone, and stay tuned for more as we expand our armies here and we play some games with them. So happy gaming, guys, and take care. Cheers.